Take this overboard now.
I want you to rock. Hey, hey, it's Tier, and welcome back to my channel, Curl Struck. So today I'm going to be doing a tutorial for a wash and go, finally. So let's go ahead and jump right on into it. The products that I use for this video is Texture ID. I finally got my hands on this. I've heard so many great things about their styling foam, so I thought I'd give it a try. So I've already started on my hair. I saved the last section to show you guys on camera. I'm just taking my sprayer mist and I'm spraying, making sure that that section is completely wet. I then take my dimming brush and make sure that it's completely detangled. But the product that you see when I'm brushing it, it had a little bit of foam in it, foam residue, so that's all that is. I'm just brushing, detangling. Then I take the foam through my hands and I pull it through my hair. As you can see that motion, since it's already detangled, I'm just running through it with my fingers, clumping it together. So this styling foam, one pump goes a very long way, which I love about this Texture ID styling foam, is that one pump literally can cover the whole section. You don't have to overdo it. One time I did two pumps on a section and it was a lot, so I'm really pleased to see that. Now I'm just taking that section and I'm doing a loose, big finger coil. I used to do it smaller when my hair was growing out. Now that my hair is more defined, I don't have to do a serious finger coil, but I just do it lightly just to make sure that it's more defined. So I wanted to give you guys a bit of an overview for the Texture ID products. For the shampoo, it is a sulfate-free clarifying cleanser in that it gently lifts away the debris and impurities known to dry out the hair and scalp. It also has honey and argan oil that provide hydration and extreme shine by sealing the moisture at the cuticles. One thing I noticed when washing my hair with this shampoo is that it foams and suds up very well, and it cleans it almost automatically. And when I wash my hair out, I can tell that it lifts a lot of that old buildup that I had in my hair. And for the conditioner, it definitely has a rich and creamy consistency to it. Definitely hydrated my hair while I was using it. Left it in for about a few minutes and also detangled it as it was in my hair. The great thing about this product is that it can also be used as a co-wash and a leave-in, which is what I used it for after I washed my hair as well. Also, when I realized that the foam was alcohol-free, I was like, I'm definitely going to give this a try. So yes, it is alcohol-free. It's also a heat protective formula that can go up to 450 degrees Fahrenheit, so it's great if you do wrap styles or roller sets or even blowouts. And it also has argan oil and honey as well to achieve that soft, radiant result. And as you can see, I am done using the product, the foam product, and I have set my hair. So what I like to do, I like to let it air dry for about a good 30 to 45 minutes, and then I will begin the diffusing process. But I do let it sit, maybe do something around the house, let it give it some time to set before I add heat. So I'm using my Ionic conditioning hair dryer, and it also came with the diffuser detachment. And so for the settings, I usually use medium speed and medium heat. I never go above that. I don't want to put too much heat on my hair. So when I start diffusing my hair is already about 50% dry. So then I just go ahead and start from the ends of my hair and then go up to the roots of my hair. We'll be right back. now my hair is completely dry and this is the finished look. Now I'm gonna go ahead and get a pick. I always make sure that my roots are 100% dry before I start messing with the roots, because you don't want to create a bunch of frizz. You want to make sure it's completely dry. So I do that, I shake my hair a bit, and then I'm out the door. Finished results. I love this foam. It left my hair extremely defined, moisturized. I've never had to just use one product and be able to get the results that I love. Usually I add a gel, but I did not have to do this. So I definitely recommend Texture ID foam. It is amazing, you guys. So I'm definitely going to do a tutorial, maybe for like flexi rods using this thermal foam, just to see how diverse it really is. So if you have any suggestions, or have if you've ever used Texture ID, just let me know how it worked for you. Also, if you have any suggestions or any videos in the future, let me know. And don't be a stranger. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram, Twitter, or Snapchat, you guys. See you next time.